Good afternoon and welcome. We're going to begin this afternoon with number 301, The God of All Grace, number 301.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Gospel today, we hear about warnings about the end of time and how we live our lives, and are we doing the things we should? I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned, that my thoughts and my words, what I've done and what I've failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Glory to God in the highest, that on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You're seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit and the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. And we pray, O Lord our God, that the constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is our full and lasting happiness to serve you with constancy, the author of all that is good. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the book of the prophet Malachi. Lo, the day is coming, blazing like an oven, when all the proud and all evildoers will be stubble. And the day that is coming will set them on fire, leaving them neither root nor branch, says the Lord of hosts. But for you who fear my name, there will arise the sun of justice with its healing rays. The word of the Lord. A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, you know how one must imitate us. For we did not act in a disorderly way among you, nor did we eat food received free from anyone. On the contrary, in toil and drudgery, night and day we worked, so as not to burden any of you. Not that we did not have the right. Rather, we wanted to present ourselves as a model for you, so that you might imitate us. In fact, when we were with you, we instructed you that if anyone was unwilling to work, neither should that one eat. We hear that some are conducting themselves among you in a disorderly way by not keeping busy, but minding the business of others. Such people we instruct and urge in the Lord Jesus Christ to work quietly and to eat their own food. The word of the Lord.
Oh,
you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Now, some people were speaking about how the temple was adorned with costly stones and votive offerings. Jesus said, "All these you see here, the days will come when there will be not one left, a stone upon another stone, that will not be thrown down." They asked him, "Teacher, when will this happen? What sign will there be when all these things are about to happen?" He answered, "See that you do not be deceived. For many will come in my name, saying, 'I am he,' and the time has come. Do not follow them. When you hear of wars and insurrections, do not be terrified, for such things must happen first, but it will not immediately be to the end." Then he said to them, "Nation will rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom. There will be powerful earthquakes, famines, and plagues from place to place, and awesome sights and mighty signs will come from the sky. Before all this happens, however, they will seize and persecute you. They will hand you over to the synagogues and to prisons. They will have you led before kings and governors because of my name. It will lead to your giving testimony. Remember, you are not to prepare your own defense beforehand, for I myself shall give you a wisdom in speaking that all your adversaries will be powerless to resist or refute. You will even be handed over by parents, brothers, relatives, and friends, and they will put some of you to death. You will be hated by all because of my name, but not a hair on your head will be destroyed. But for your perseverance, you will secure your lives." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
Now, I understand last Saturday I gave a sermon and the microphone was not on. Y'all remember that?
Yes.
If that happens, wave at me, okay? Let me know. So, hello. So that I know what's going on. I ordered new vestments for Father X because we did not have a set that matches. And I ordered them from over in Italy. And they did it in centimeters instead of inches. So if Father X is a runt, he's got to go to Omar the tent maker to get it fixed. Okay? So I tried, you know, what the heck? All right, so if he gets some little runt priest around here, okay, it ain't gonna work, all right? So I thought I knew the conversion table. Evidently I didn't, okay? That's the fun of being a pastor. All right, I'm not a pastor, I'm an administrator, okay? Say, pastors, you can't fire, administrators, you can. Okay, so I'm on a slippery slope here. You know that, don't you? Yeah. You call 1-800-SHELTON, I'm out the door, right? There was a philosopher, Kierkegaard, and he told a parable about his time when he was in Europe. And it seems that there was a theater was putting on a review. It was one act after another. And as the review went on, each act got better than the next. And the people were thrilled. They loved it. This was wonderful. And then about halfway through the time, the manager of the theater walked out and he said, "Now, I don't want to make everybody upset, but the building's on fire and I need you in an orderly fashion to leave." They clapped for it. They thought this was funny. They thought he was kidding. He said louder. He says, This is not a joke. The theater is on fire. You need to leave. The people clapped again. They didn't get it. Finally, the whole theater catches fire and many of them die. They didn't pay attention. Now, the readings today and all this week coming up, if you come to daily mass, are about the end of time. And you know, you've seen people before walk around with billboards on it, you know, the end is coming and all that good stuff. We don't know when it happens. We have no idea what it is, but as a people, we don't pay attention to a lot of things we should. Example, people with heart conditions don't get the exercise they should. People with high blood pressure eat lots of snacks with salt in them. People with high cholesterol eat fatty foods. People who have diabetes can't resist dessert. And how many warnings have we had? How many times you've been on TV and they're trying to sell you a drug that you can't get because it costs too much, that is for that? And the warning, you need to correct your life. We're not good at that. We don't pay attention. Now, as far as the end of the world and our end of time here, that's up to God. But the question is, how prepared are we? How prepared are we to meet the Lord? How prepared are we to give an accounting of our lives? And when we give that accounting, will it be good or will we be embarrassed? We're not good at those things because we don't want to think about it. And yet, we know day after day people die that you don't think will die. Day after day accidents happen to people you think would never have an accident. Day after day, people drop dead from things they didn't pay attention to. What is our answer? How do we go before the Lord? And when we do, are we ready? I want to propose a couple things that might help us. One is, spend 5 minutes a day in peace and quiet. Let God speak to you. Let God talk to you. Let Him say the things that you need to hear that will prepare you to meet Him. We set alarm clocks for all kinds of things, don't we? Well, unless you're retired, then you don't care, right? I miss that. But we do it. People set alarm clocks to get up. They set alarm clocks to take your medicine. They set alarm clocks to watch your favorite TV show. They set alarm clocks to watch whatever sporting event they want to watch. How about setting an alarm on your phone to remind you to stop and say thank you to the Lord for what He's given you? To say, I appreciate what's in my life. I appreciate the opportunity you've given me to live. The last thing is, read the scripture for next week before you come to church. Give yourself a chance to reflect on God's word before I come up and tell you what I want you to think about, so that you think about what you need to think about. Now, those things are not going to guarantee to get you to heaven, but they're guaranteed to set you on the right path, where you will be honest with yourself and honest with the Lord. Let's pray. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, Lord of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the Holy Spirit, incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, that proceeds from the Father and the Son. The Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, the life of the world to come. Amen. We now present our needs to our loving God.
For those who are imprisoned or persecuted for their faith, that they rejoice to share in Christ's suffering, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For people in every land, that they be able to worship God in peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For families divided by faith, that Christ restore them to unity, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our community, that we persevere in time of trials, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Sandra Sackstetter, Bud Botenbender, and Sonny Yates, who were buried from our church in the last 2 weeks, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those whose names are inscribed in our Book of Remembrance, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Francis and Mary Clark, and families for whom this Mass is being offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord,
gracious God, we thank you for the gift of the opportunity to come before you in worship. We offer you prayers that we need in our lives. Bless each and every one of us and be with us in our times of need. And we make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Number 356, Miracle of Grace, number 356.
Thank you.
Pray now. Let our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept sacrifice at your hands. Praise the Lord. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that we offer you the sight of your majesty. May obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you, and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father of mercies and faithful God. For you have given us Jesus Christ, your Son, as our Lord and Redeemer. He always showed compassion for the children and for the poor, for the sick and for the sinner. He became the neighbor to the oppressed and the afflicted. By word and deed, he announced to the world that you are our Father, and that you care for all your sons and daughters. So with all the angels and saints, we exalt and bless your name and sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Glorified, O God, who loves the human race and always walks with us in the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son present in our midst. We are gathered by his love. What is now and for his disciples, so now for us. He opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask you to send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he suffered, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and he said the blessing. He broke the bread and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, he took the chalice and he gave you thanks. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, to be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection we accept us free.
Therefore, Holy Fathers, we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through the passion and death of the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand. We proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor upon the oblation of your church, in which you show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and granted by the power of the Spirit of your love, we will be counted now until the days of eternity among the members of your Son, whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Shelton, our Bishop, and all the bishops, priests, deacons, religious, and the entire people you've made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire us in words and action to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people might be raised to new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the fullness of the resurrection, give them fullness of life. Grant also to us when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to the eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints. We shall praise and exalt you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Conform to divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Gracious and grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress. As we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, power, and glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you say to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul.
number 344, Spirit and Grace, number 344.
Let us pray. Having partaken in the gifts of this sacred mystery, we humbly ask you, Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us, make us grow in charity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Again this year, we're going to participate in the clothing coat drive that we did a few years back. If you have a new, would like to donate a new or a gently used clean coat, bring it next week. We're going to do it between now and Thanksgiving, so we only got a short period of time. We're in the process of collecting names for invitations to the volunteer dinner on Sunday the 11th of December. The invitations will be mailed out shortly. You have to RSVP by December the 1st. Admission is by ticket only. For Christmas this year, we're collecting items for St. John's Center and food items for our St. Vincent de Paul. The list will be in the bulletin shortly, so if you'd like to help us, that'll come up after Thanksgiving, okay? I'm just planning ahead, guys, getting things ready, all right? Catholic Services Appeal, we're up to $17,000 and 74 donors. I need more help. If you've got a yellow envelope at home, fill it out and bring it to me, okay? I'm trying to stay employed, you know? The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And Mass is ended. Let's go in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Number 450, O God, our help in ages past.